Welcome back to the channel. I hope you all guys are doing just fine. So without wasting much time, let's jump straight into the tutorial. Today's tutorial will be about a check layer, that is a luminosity check layer. A check layer is a layer which is used to look at a particular attribute of an image at one time. There are three most important attributes in an image, that is hue, saturation and luminosity. In this tutorial, we will be talking about the luminosity check layer and how to create those check layers and when to use the luminosity check layer. A luminosity check layer is a check layer which removes all the colors and saturation from the image and only keeps its luminosity values based on the human perception. So let's jump straight into the tutorial. First, we will be seeing a practical example of a luminosity check layer. For that, we have an example here in which we have a landscape composite which I will be using for future composite very soon. I will open the landscape composite group. I will create a check layer. Just look at the steps. Do not try to understand them now. I will be explaining it to you a bit later. So when we create the check layer, we can see that the background is a lot darker than the foreground, that is the subject. So we can use a curves adjustment layer which is clipped to the subject, and we can decrease the luminosity. While doing this, the colors do not hamper our mind and it is easy for us to match the colors of the image. This is the reason why we create luminosity check layers or any check layers while doing compositing or doing some stuff like compositing. I will be showing you some examples when to use the check layers. Just stay tuned to the last. So let's move on to our first part of the tutorial, where we will be talking about the process of creating a check layer. There are two methods to create a check layer, that is a solid color layer or a vibrance layer. First of all, we will see the solid color method. In this solid color method, we will create a solid color adjustment layer with a zero saturation and any brightness or hue. Hue can be anything, brightness can be anything, but the saturation should be zero. Let's take about 50% gray, click on OK, and then change its blend mode. This is very important, do not forget it, and change its blend mode to color. When you change its blend mode to color, we can only see the luminosity values of those colors. See, we can see no colors here. If we turn this off, we can see the colors here, and when I turn this on, you can see only the luminosity values. The second method is the vibrance adjustment layer, and decreasing the saturation of the vibrance to negative 100. Not the vibrance, the saturation to negative 100. Similar to the solid color layer, we can see here that the colors are taken away and we can only see the luminosity value. When you turn this on, you can see that there is a bit of a difference in both of these, but I will be explaining it to you when to use which of the check layers. Now many of you would be thinking that why I am using the saturation of the vibrant saturation layer and not the saturation of the hue and saturation layer. Here we can see that this also has a saturation slider like the vibrant saturation slider. If we go to hue and saturation and decrease the saturation of this layer, we can see that the first row here and the second row here is completely same. If you use the eyedropper tool, you can see that these luminosity values are completely same. But when you look at them with your naked eye, with the colors in them, we can see that this green looks a bit darker, but when you turn on hue and saturation layer, it does not show that difference. Corresponding to which, if you turn on the solid color layer or the vibrance layer, you can see that there is a bit of a difference in those colors, and you can make out those difference very nicely in this solid color or vibrance layer. From here, we move over to the next part, that why does this happen? This part is just for the nerds to understand how this works. If you do not want to watch it, you can skip this part to a timestamp mentioned in the description. The hue and saturation layer is completely based on mathematical conditions. This will mathematically compute the values and decrease all the saturation to negative 100, means it will remove the saturation completely. But when you use the solid color or the vibrant saturation layer, this will be based on the human perception algorithm. Human perception algorithm means that when you see with your naked eye, you can see that these colors have the same brightness. These two are at same brightness, that is 100% brightness and 100% brightness. But due to the low saturation value, these look a bit darker. According to human perception, this is darker, and vibrance uses that algorithm of human perception and makes them darker. So while compositing, you will never look for the mathematical conditions. You will look for the human perception or what you see. That's why we will never use the hue and saturation layer while compositing. So let's delete that and forget about it. From here, we move on to the next part, in which we will be discussing when to use which of the check layer, the solid color or the vibrance. Here, if we turn on the solid color, you can see there is a sharp edge in the reds and the yellows. But when you turn on the vibrance layer, there is a sharp edge in the blues. Let me type it for you. Sharp edge in blues. Sharp edge in reds. So this is the key point which will help us to determine when to use the vibrance and when to use the color fill layer. For that, we will be seeing two examples. One of them is the landscape composite which I used just a few minutes ago. This is a landscape composite in which we have a subject and a landscape, and we will not be dealing with the skin colors here. In this, we can see that there is lot of blues and greens, that is the cool colors, where we saw the sharp edge in vibrance. So for this step, we'll be using the vibrance adjustment layer. So you can come to the conclusion here that vibrance adjustment layer will be used when we are doing some landscape compositing and there is no changes in the skin color. If you turn on the solid color and zoom into the image and turn it on and off, you can see that there is a tad bit of difference in the skin color and there is no difference in the background and the foreground. So when we are dealing with landscape composites, we should use vibrance adjustment layer. Next, we move over to the step where we have to use the solid color adjustment layer. This is the image which I used in the previous tutorial. You can just watch it. It is linked up in the card. When we are doing some job related to the skin color, we should use the solid color adjustment layer. If you turn on the solid color adjustment layer, we can see that we can clearly see the blotches in the skin. But when you turn on the vibrance saturation layer, you can see that that contrast goes away. If you turn this on and off, you can see that there is a better contrast in the skin blotches. So while doing something related to the skin color, we should use the solid color adjustment layer. and when we do some landscape compositing which contains more of blues and greens, we should use the vibrance adjustment layer. So this brings us to the end of the tutorial. At the end, you need to remember only 4 important points and forget about all the other steps. All the other steps are for your concept and they won't be required while you're compositing or doing your work. Those 4 important steps are that we create checklists when we have to look at one particular property at a time. That may be hue, saturation or luminosity. The 2 other checklists will be discussed very soon in the further tutorials. For now, just focus on the luminosity checklist. Secondly, there are 2 methods to make luminosity check layers, that is the solid color fill layer with 0 saturation or the vibrance adjustment layer with the saturation slider set to -100. Thirdly, never to use the saturation slider of hue and saturation layer because it is based on mathematical conditions and not on human perception algorithms. And lastly, when to use which of the adjustment layer. When you are dealing with skin tones, oranges, yellows, reds, use the solid color fill layer with its blend mode set to color. When you are dealing with landscape compositing which contains more of greens, blues, magentas, use the vibrance adjustment layer. And to end the tutorial, I have a tip for you. There is a pro tip for you that you can use any of those adjustment layers at any point of time because the difference between them in real life is very less. So it won't make much of a difference if you use any of them in either of the cases. So that was it for the video. Thanks for watching and good night.